بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وعلى من اتبع سنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي، اللهم امين. ثم اما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today it is a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we return back to Friday prayer in the masjid. And actually we are getting closer and closer every day to the month of Ramadan. We are waiting the advent of this holy month, this great month, the month of mercy, the month of forgiveness, the month of and every one of us should do his best to be saved from the hell fire. And inshallah today I'd like to address an important point before we find ourselves in this month without getting prepared to get the fruits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for those who are doing their best in the ibadah in this month. So the point today, the important point today that I'd like to address quickly during this short reminder is the importance. If every one of us, my brothers and sisters, and also myself, to settle issues with our brothers, to settle issues with our brothers. It's an important part of our effort towards purification of our souls before getting access to the holy month of Ramadan. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the authentic hadith narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu and reported by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تقاطعوا ولا تدابروا ولا تباغضوا ولا تحاسدوا وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا، لا يحل لمسلم أن يحجر أخاه فوق ثلاث. It's not only reported by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. It is متفق عليه. It means that this is reported in almost all the authentic books of Sunnah. Then Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لا تقاطعوا. Don't stop talking to one another. Don't stop talking to one another. ولا تدابروا. Don't show your backs to one another. ولا تباغضوا. Don't harbor hatred. Don't harbor enmity inside your hearts towards one another. ولا تحاسدوا. And don't be jealous of one another. وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا. And become fellow servants, for brothers and slaves or servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at this important point here. لا يحل لمسلم أن يهجر أخاه فوق ثلاث. It's not lawful for a Muslim to stop talking to his brother beyond three nights. Beyond three nights, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained in other hadith, as we will address inshallah after that. So this is important point, important issue that every one of us should consider for before getting access to the month of Ramadan. Today, inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, I divide this topic into two parts. Today, inshallah, I'll address the first part. So what are the measures? What are the measures that we need to consider in order to achieve this? Settling the issues among ourselves. Settling the issues among ourselves according to what is recommended by Quran and what is recommended by authentic Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, I'll talk about the first category, which is the what we can call the internal or the intrinsic measures. And maybe not many people are aware about the importance of this. The internal or the intrinsic measures. So number one, dua. Number one, ad-dua, supplication. If someone has an issue with his brother, and he is willing to settle these issues, number one, ad-dua, even by name. Because all these issues are within the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in Surah Al-Anfal, وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ لَوْ أَنْفَقَتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِنَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala joined their hearts. If you had given away or spent all the riches in the earth, you could not have joined their hearts. It's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that joined his hearts. He is all almighty, all wise. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in Surah Al-Imran, وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. And remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala among you. The favor of Allah upon you. The favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you is إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. You were once enemies. Actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala joined your hearts together. فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. And you became by his blessing, brothers. Okay? This is the first important point. And this addresses an important issue also to us, that even if there are enmity between brothers, it can be changed into friendship, into relation, which is based on mercy and love among brothers. The second and the last point to finish this khutbah for the interesting missions. Number one, we said dua, and number two, to be humble towards our brothers. To be humble towards our brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَنْ يَرْتَدَّ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَعِزَّةٍ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. We will focus here on the description, أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what should be the attitude, indicates to us, what should be the attitude of a Muslim towards his brothers? أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, humble towards their brothers, their believing brothers. أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This means that any brother who has power, who has authority, who has influence, who has wealth, should not use any of these things to suppress the others, to persecute the others, to inflict physical or psychological harm towards the others. So these are the two points that the time allows today to address regarding this important issue. So number one, dua, and number one, to be humble towards the others if we are considering for the point of settling issues among us and purifying our souls before the advent of the holy month of Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه به ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Today, to summarize, we addressed the issue of the point of trying to address to settle issues among ourselves as brothers before the advent of the month of Ramadan, and we talked about the first category of the measures which are recommended by the Quran and the Sunnah, which are the internal measures related to intention. And we mentioned two points. The first is to keep on making dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reforms among ourselves. And the second point is to have the attitude of being humble towards the others inside ourselves. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا ما كان من توفيق فمن الله سبحانه وتعالى وما كان من ذلل فمن نفسي ومن الشيطان. Whatever of correct things I said are by the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever of mistakes I made are from myself and from الشيطان. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. وعكم السلام.